In this presentation, we will learn how to assign the content of one pointer to another pointer. So let's get started. Suppose we have this variable I, which is initialized with value 10, and here is the pictorial representation of this variable I, which is initialized with value 10, and the address of this variable is 1000. Apart from this, we have these two pointers P and Q, which are pointing to the object of same data type, int, and here is the representation of these two pointers P and Q. Apart from this, with the help of this statement p equal ampersand of I, we are trying to assign the address of variable I to this pointer p. We can see here the address of variable I is 1000. Therefore, with the help of this statement, we will simply assign this address to pointer p, so that the pointer p will point to variable I, right? Now, with the help of this statement, we are trying to assign the content of P to Q. P contains the address 1000, which is the address of variable I. So with the help of this statement, we can give this content to Q. Now Q will also contain 1000, which is the address of variable I. Therefore, Q will also point to this variable. Both these pointers are pointing to the same location. With the help of this printf function, we can print the content which is stored in this location 1000. With the help of this star p, we can print the content which is stored in this address 1000. And we can see 10 is stored in this address 1000. And similarly, with the help of the star q, we can again print the value 10. Therefore, the output of this program is 10, 10. But please note that Q equals to P is not same as star Q equals star P. We already know that if we simply assign the content of P to Q, this is what has happened, right? But what happens if we have these two variables I and J, which are initialized with the different values, and P and Q are the pointers which are pointing to different memory locations? P contains the address of I and Q contains the address of J. Here is the pictorial representation of pointers P and Q and variables I and J. I contains value 10 and J contains value 20. They are different variables, therefore they acquire different memory locations. P contains the address of I and Q contains the address of J. With the help of this statement, what we are trying to do is, we are simply trying to access the content of the location which is pointed by the pointer P. This is what star P means, right? Star is the dereference operator, which helps us to take the value stored at the location pointed by the pointer. Here we can see this pointer P is pointing to 1000 location, which contains value 10. Therefore, with the help of star P, we are simply trying to access this content 10. And with the help of star Q, we are trying to access this content 20. So with the help of this statement, we are trying to replace this value 20 by this value 10. Therefore, after this assignment statement, value 20 will get replaced by 10. We can clearly see that Q equals to P is not same as star Q equals to star P. Here is one homework problem for you. Predict the output of the following program. Your job is to predict the output of this program. You are always welcome to leave your answers in the comment section below. Okay, friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.